Vicky Brown seeking another 15-foot looper to continue the Great Taste rampage. They're now up by 15. It's down to 13 after Rudy Distrito sank an under goal stand.
Yes, Distrito came into the ballgame for Marcus Saldana. Very good move on the part of coach, assistant coach Kumaren. Saldana couldn't get this game going, and he needs a guy like Distrito at this point. Good steal there by Magnolia.
And here's Vivo de Banes bringing the ball downtown for Magnolia. Distrito, Mananzala trying to come up with a preemptive foul, but they just let it go, and block comes in for the unopposed 2 points. 11-point lead for Great Taste. Still time for Magnolia to catch up, but they have to dredge every ounce of energy and every ounce of willpower left in their systems to salvage this game. Carpio, the bounce pass to Abby King, and Great Taste continues to run amok.
That's what happens when you double team a person and they get the ball free to the 3 second area. Usually it's a 2-on-1 situation, and they ran it very well.
107-94. Once again, the Magnolians falling right into the alley of the Great Tasters. 13-point advantage for Great Taste, and Norman Black misses a point by Grange, and Joe Binion beat him to the rebound with a foul by Black as he tried to steal from behind.
And there's another thing creeping up against the Magnolia Ice Cream Makers. Right now they have 17 fouls and they are in penalty.
Wow, with 5 minutes to go, Great Taste can really go on fishing expeditions now.
Brown,
all odds seem to be stacked up against Magnolia.
And that's what just what happened, Joe. You just called it the pressing defense. Rabanes commits a foul against Banal.
It'll be a penalty situation now. And by the way, we'd like to remind you about the delayed telecast of game number 6 in the struggle for third place between NCC and Dwai. David Pope will also be on our PBA mailbox portion. If the championship playoffs between Great Taste and Magnolia ends tonight, so does the battle for third place. It's very important that you watch that game in the delayed telecast.
Well, Great Taste has the brakes falling for it. They get all the offensive rebounds, the follow-up there. Abby King again controls the ball. He tries to dribble out. Loses it.
No, yes, he lost it too. And everybody pointing to each other. He had the last touch. No, he had the last touch.
Last touch called against Rabanes. 14-point lead for Great Taste with only 4 minutes and 48 seconds left.
Time is grimly against the Magnolia Ice Cream Makers. And Totoy de la Cruz spots a foul.
An intentional foul call. Deliberate foul called against Distrito. Using his right leg there. Let's see if we caught that in slow-mo. There you can see Binion there, and Binion trying to go for the ball. Distrito putting his right foot out. Referee is calling it very well, very close.
And the Great Taste fans are delirious in the stands. They're in the grip of championship fever. 4 minutes and 44 to go. Mathematically, technically, it's still possible for Magnolia to catch up. But definitely, the momentum is on the side of Great Taste Coffee. Joe Binion performing splendidly from the stripe to make it a 16-point lead for Great Taste. Time down to 4 minutes and 40 seconds. Rudy Distrito with a penetration. Good pass to Dante Gonzalo, who fails to deliver from 10. And the Great Tasters pulling down the rebound. They have the luxury of running down the clock, but there is a foul readily given up by Dante Gonzalo.
And since they are in penalty, that will send Banal to the 15-foot line. We have another timeout by Magnolia. Joe will be back.
A very impressive 17-point lead now for Great Taste as Joel Manal sinks the first of two charities with only 4 minutes and 29 seconds remaining, 111-94. 2-for-2 by Joel Manal. And the Great Taste fans are already whooping it up. With a good 4 minutes and 26 to go, they're up by a seemingly insurmountable 16-point advantage.
It's still premature at this point, you know, but they can sense the kill. Norman tries to get it back, and he misses.
Here's Joe Binion. Jimmy Manizala quickly bring it down court for the Great Taste Coffee men, Joey Carpio, and here's Abby King in the left quarter court. They have the luxury of running down the clock at this point. And yes, they're looking to do exactly that. They've got 8 seconds to go in their shot clock. And here's Abiking. Unmolested. He misses. Ball falling right to the hands of Danny Gonzalgo, who tops it over to Noli Bonatti and Rudy Distrito for the ball-carrying Chures. Foul, Jimmy Mananzala, and they can very well afford to give up that foul. That's only their 14th foul.
Yes, they actually have three to give with only 3 minutes and 48 seconds left in this ball game. 18-point lead for Great Taste.
Norman Blyke, he's played heroically tonight, but it looks like a losing cause. Three-point shot. They'll have to go to those birdies now. All right, here's Joey. Can't shake off Banal. Can't get a clear beat on the basket, but Norman Black gets it at point blank.
Well, they should try three-point shots, but if they can't, they might as well be contented with a two, you know, and then play very tough defense, gambling defense.
Right now, their defense is not exactly that great. But Joe Binion is allowing them to set up because the Great Tasters are really playing that clock. 11 seconds in their shot clock, 3:14 in the game clock. Here's Joe making his move. The one-handed shot is up, and it falls right to the hands of Norman Black. The Magnolias have not yet given up. They're still hoping for something, somewhere, some miracle to happen.
There's a foul given up by Abby King, which will send Norman Black to the 15-foot line.
That's the fifth personal for Abby King. One more, it's going to be the showers for Abby. And we've got another timeout. We shall return.
Timeout, Great Taste Coffee.
Making it a ball game and a 16-point lead staring down the Magnolians right in the face. Make that a 15-point deficit now. But time is definitely against him. Dr. J?
Norman Black has really extended himself here. 39 points, made that 40. Still doing perfect from the 15-foot line. Full court press by Magnolia.
It's been a heroic effort for Norman Black tonight, but look at Abby King getting away. See how he did that so smartly. He could have taken the layup with a good mile away from Noli Bonatti, but he deliberately waited for Bonatti to pull up to him and then put up the shot just so he can go for a three-point play.
Yes.
Look at this.
He really baited him. Went up there, even was trying to go for the duck. Actually, there's Bonatti pushing off. Abe makes the shot. Back to a 16-point lead. He could make it 17.
Abe King, a tower of power for Great Taste. But then, let us not forget Ricky Brown, who's being kept on hold right now. He's been the heart and soul of this Great Taste offensive. We've always believed that the fortunes of Great Taste always ride with the performance of Ricky Brown. Tonight, he performed exceptionally well. And look at this, a 17-point lead for them.
Yes, 39 points already. He could practically break his record if he were fielded back into the ballgame. But he was kept on hold. When Magnolia threatened and they took the lead in the fourth quarter, it was Ricky Brown doing a one-man demolition job.
Exactly. Now it's Abby King bearing the cudgels for Great Taste. Joe Binion getting into the act. Let's not forget Joe Binion's contribution, too. He came up with 26 points, plucked down 15 rebounds. 2 minutes and 19 seconds to go. Binion and King are giving each other the bear hug. I guess they know that they have the crown in their pockets.
With only 2 minutes and 19 seconds, 17-point lead, and two free throws by Joy Carpio, well, it might be the end of the road for Magnolia, but not a bad road. It's been a glorious one. They played very well here in the open.
Dr. J, remember Little Big Horn when Sitting Bull and his Braves smothered a badly outnumbered Colonel Custer and his 50 brave men or so? They did not scout him in respect for his terrific fighting spirit. And I believe Great Taste will not scout Magnolia tonight because the ice cream makers have absolutely nothing to be ashamed of. They have absolutely nothing to hang their hands about because they've done extremely well. Their being in the finals was itself more. All right, we're in the end game, but it is somewhat anticlimactic. It's a sure win now for the Great Taste Coffee men with only a minute and 43 to go and a 17-point lead. But look at the Magnolians. They're not throwing in the towel yet. They're fighting to the finish. Norman Black. Loose ball foul. Time left, a minute and 36. Like I was saying earlier, Magnolia had already won a championship by itself when they enter the finals in this fashion.
Yes, Abby King fouls out of the ball game, gets a lot of high five and high ten. Victorino sent into the ball game to replace him, and Brown will be given his last pause at acclamation by the crowd.
An opportunity.